Hey guys, VintageBeef back in action. Time to enchant myself a sword. I need a sword and a pick. So I'm going to enchant both those things right now. I have level 45. I'm hoping to get a 40. Wait, is this not activated properly? No, it is. Why did I get such low options right at the beginning? Interesting. So again, I keep hearing different stories that this changes the enchant. This does not change the enchant and just changes the numbers. So I'm scared. Oh, there's a 46. I don't want to take that chance. So is there something blocking? Oh, by the way, I'm wearing a pumpkin for a face. Because I don't want to die. Why is that going so slowly? Come on, give me a 45. I don't want to do this and take the chance. At least, I know this way takes longer, but at least I know for sure that the enchantment is actually changing. See, if I did this, it's a level 20 down here, and now I start doing this, it's sort of, I don't know, man, I don't know if that changed it. It's a 44. We're going to find out. This is either going to be a really good enchant at 44, or a pretty average enchant at level 20. Smite 5. Well, I guess that works well on skeletons and zombies, so I guess it's not too bad. Anyway, back to work. Gonna go kill a bunch more Endermen, get my level up to 40-something again, and then enchant this diamond pickaxe, and hopefully we get a good working diamond pick. By the way, I turned the sound off because these guys are so annoying. So yeah, let's go ahead and get our pumpkin face back so I know what I'm punching them with. I'm gonna punch them with zombie flesh. Alright guys, I'm going to do this for a little while, and I'll be back soon. Okay, I'm back. Time for another enchant. I did some research while I was leveling there, and apparently there's a 0.3% chance that you can get Smite 5 with a level 22, and there's like a 13% chance you can get it with a level 44. So the chances are good that yes, clicking with items does change the enchant. Whoa, 45 right off the bat. I think we're just going to go for this one. Efficiency 3. Oh, well, at least it is a good working pick. I mean, it could have been efficiency 4. An unbreaking 4. Or efficiency 7,000. An unbreaking 6,000. That would have been good too. This is hard to do without the crosshairs. All right, I'm gonna go back to the village that I'm working on. Some things have happened there. Some sad things. But I will share those things with you once we get back there. All right, we are back at the village. I forgot I had that food in there. That might come in handy, because I'm down to... In fact, let's go ahead and grab some fishy. Some fish. Back at the village, and look what I did. I took all of you guys' advices and put fences around each of my walkways here. I think it looks pretty cool, too. It looks really, like, cozy and claustrophobic, sort of, which is the kind of feel I'm going for. I want this to be, like, a super sort of, like, an overpopulated village. But you guys might be wondering, where are all my villagers? Well, my friends, they all died. No, I'm just kidding. They did not die. However, one is missing. I closed these guys in here. I was making one of those, you know, Doc made a tutorial on how to increase village population, I guess. And I was making that, and I had 3 villagers. It would have worked out perfectly. I have these 5... Or I made a 5x5 space here, is going to close this off, have one villager inside of it, and have the other 2 on the outside trying to breed with the one on the inside, therefore breeding with each other and creating endless amounts of tiny villagers. However, one of the villagers got loose. And I don't know where he went. I'm pretty sure he's dead because it's been like 3 Minecraft days now. So, he's probably gone forever. Which is, it's a damn shame, because because that would have worked out nicely. Now I only have two villagers. They're both in there. I'm pretty sure this method will not work now. I think I needed one trapped in there and two or more on the outside, but yeah. I'm pretty sure that won't work. Let's get rid of these pearls. So now I guess I just have to wait for them to breed naturally, which is not good. Oh, no, it wasn't your internet, Anders. We all got DC'd. Okay, let's get rid of these Ender pearls. Put them in my miscellaneous chest. I got these chests a little more organized. See? Huh? This is my miscellaneous chest. That's why it's not organized. Let's grab a whole bunch of stuff. Am I out of torches too? Is it just me getting wild lag spikes? Been okay for me. Torches. We're gonna work on a couple houses today, one or two. And then I don't know what I'm gonna do because I really want those villagers to populate, to breed. But it's tough because there's only two of them now. Oh, by the way, the ones back to being AFK, so you guys. Okay. Lights. The one that I was expecting to be stupid and run away is the white coat one. The librarian, or whatever he is. But that was not the guy that got away. The guy that got away was the commoner. So he escaped. He disappeared. He's probably gone forever. And I'll never see him again. Which is a shame. That's gotta stop. Let's make some stairs. Oop, that's a different kind of stair. Okay, well, let's make one more, I guess. Like this. Let's put this back in here. What do we got? Fences. I'm gonna need some fences. I'm gonna need a lot of fence, actually. So, let's go ahead and take, well, we don't need any of this wood. Let's go ahead and do that. Like that. Might as well. I'm gonna need a ton of fence for this project here. Bam, 64 fences. Right away from a bunch of wood. What am I saying? Okay. I might as well make the rest of these two into torches here. Alright, also I should put... Let's get this sword out of my inventory. Let's just use a Smite 5. Good for killing zombies. It'll come in handy. Oh, I still have no arrows though. It's okay. We'll make do without the arrows. So what else should I bring? So I got my fences. Aha! I need to bring some of... Well, maybe a couple doors. Let's get a couple doors in our inventory here. Let's get... Ooh, I need more of this wood. I gotta go chop that down. That stinks. I do have 41 on me, though, so we'll use that for now. Fences, planks. Probably need some planks. Let's take these planks here. Oh, Milby, I don't know the answer to that, my friend. I would help you if I could. Not sure. Up a hill, it's probably only like three blocks. Look, there's an iron golem in the water. By the way, you guys are right. Hey, there's Doc. I was just using his breeding machine poorly. You guys are right. The villagers, the iron golems all ended up in the water. Like at the bottom of the water. But they don't... BB? BB? Oh, be back later. Okay. Yeah, they don't drown, which is cool. So here is the little... I'm not sure if I even showed you guys this house last time. It's up on top of this hill here. I don't think I did. Maybe I did. I don't know. But yeah, look. See, you got the pathway. It leads everywhere. This one goes up here. This is blocked off for now, but eventually there will be a path to go in further into the jungle. But there's also... Right here. There's a path right here that I made to go into the jungle as well. Man, it would be great if I found that villager. But I doubt it. He's long dead now. It's been at least 3 Minecraft days since I saw him, so... sadness ensues. So I hope you guys enjoyed the previous episode where I brought all these guys to the village. I had a bunch of fun editing it with all that fancy music and stuff. Oh, that's not going to look good at all. I was hoping to make this one a little bit different, but the doors kind of mess you up. I guess I could do this, though. But then that would have to be... You can hear the villagers downstairs opening and closing those doors over and over again. There's like stuff growing in here, man. Like, get out of here, stuff. Alright, we're just going to do this good old-fashioned way. We'll use the stairs for the roof. Okay. So, now, let's go ahead and climb. I didn't bring any, like, pillaring material, did I? I did not. I'd like to get up there. I guess we'll use wood just for the sake of not going back up to the top and... or back up to the bottom and getting dirt. So let's go ahead and do this, then. Yeah, okay. Well, I guess I have material now. Whoa! This thing takes out... Wow. It takes out wood like a champ. Okay. did not expect that. Let's go ahead and get these then. So, this village isn't just going to be houses. There's going to be... I'm going to make a fishing port probably over there along the shore. Sort of like a typical coastline. You'll see some fishing ports and maybe some fish stands and stuff with the wool, the wool top parts, the wool, I don't know what to call it. You know what I mean. But yeah, there's going to be all that stuff. Mostly working on the houses now because I want these guys to repopulate, and hopefully they do that. Oh, this is going to be tough. No. Okay, this is... Can I do this? Yes. I don't want to break the trees. I'm trying to keep it as natural as possible. Did I take out this wood with my shovel as well? I may have. Ooh, that's going to be hard to do. Looks like... Oh no, I could probably use this. Like that. Let's get over here. Yes. Will this work? Yes. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and take this wooden pillar down with our shovel. That is crazy. It's faster than my axe. Okay, get up. Do that. Okay. Now what do we got? Oh, we didn't do that side. Dang it! All right, let's pillar up with wood again. It's a good thing we could take it down quickly. And it looks like I made... Oh, and I used, just to change it up a slight bit, I used some jungle wood for the floor. No big deal, but I'm just going to have little tiny variations that you guys probably wouldn't even have noticed if I didn't tell you. And that's just for me. What did I do this for? That was dumb. That shovel is so much faster than my axe. It's hilarious. All right, so this goes there. Let's climb up over here. The next house I build, where am I going to put it? I want to do some tree houses, but that looks like it's only going to be in that area there. And they're going to be connected by bridges that, you know, they kind of look like rope bridges, but they're not really because they're wooden on the bottom. But you know what I mean. Hey, look, it's a creeper. Oh, man, I'm still hoping that one day I will see that... villager's beautiful face walking up and saying, "Hey, Beef, I'm here, man. I ain't dead. Thank you so much for saving me from my village that was being attacked by zombies. To show my appreciation, I have left your village behind and moved on to get murdered by zombies. Stupid villager. Man, the villager AI is not good. Okay, can I do everything from here? I think I can. Beautiful. Like I said before, I'm trying not to disturb any of the natural vegetation, which is why the houses are sort of up and down everywhere, because I'm building them on top of dirt and leaves and all kinds of great stuff. These two iron golems, all the other ones are just gone. I managed to get the ones in the water out of the water by punching them. I did a ton of damage to them probably, but it worked. So, let's get some of these here. This is going to be annoying. We have to break this one. Let's get this down with our shovel. Is there still... No, there's no more. Okay. So, I'm going to have to break this leaf, which is a shame. But this one will be fine. There's my fence. Tons of wood is going to be spent on this little project here. And I know that this wood, a few people mentioned that I should be using jungle wood, but I just don't like the look of jungle wood. And I think it adds a little more variety if I'm using different type of wood. If I was using jungle wood for this, then am I going to be able to do this? Oh, pro. Beautiful. Oh, this is nice. Worked out nicely with the tree there. Look at that. Look at that. Floating block of dirt. Okay, so here's another home, and I'll eventually put stuff in there too. Maybe a bed in each home, and a crafting table and a furnace. That's about it. Don't want to spend too much time on something that will not be used. I'm going to cover that up with leaves. But this is nice, though. I mean, the villagers can't get out. I still want to trap them inside there because I'm very scared. I'm really scared. I guess I could let them out. You guys... happen to have any babies yet? What time is it? Oh, it's getting night. It's closer to night than it is to day right now, so I'm just gonna leave them in there for today. And maybe when it, I'm nervous about this, but maybe when it turns... When morning comes, I'll let them out and let them roam free. Of course, with all these fences here, I don't think they can get out. This is what I'm using to climb out right now. I gotta put some leaves here too, leaves above this roof. It's gonna look nice, guys. Trust me. It's gonna look real nice. Oh, and I confirmed with Etho that villagers do produce different types of villagers, no matter what type they are. Oh, it's my phone. Don't worry about it. That's good. Let's go ahead and put the pillar here like that. And then this one is supported. Well, no, it's not supported. And again, I could just put dirt in there, but I'm trying to keep this as natural as possible. So, I might fill in some leaves, though. That's the only thing, really, that I'm doing that's not very natural is filling in leaves. So, let's get over here. Let's scope out the spot for our next house. Okay, so this is the path that's going to lead right through here. Okay. Whoa. There, that villager. I guess it's just him glitching out through... That looked like the purple one, though. Oh my gosh. Nah, that's the guys below. Oh man, I got hopeful there for a second. That's just the guys below. Dang. That damn villager had to be stupid. Okay, the next one, I think this is a good spot right here. So let's leave some space for the walkway, and I'm going to have to destroy some leaves here for the walkway. So walkway's going to come around here, so let's do this, like this, and destroy that leaf, come up, and then the next house could be right here. Maybe not, because I'd like to have it so that this walkway continues. Could make the house here. If I make the house here, then I'd have to extend the walkway. Yeah, I might have to destroy this bit more of these leaves here, but that's what we're going to do. Next house is going to be right here. So, let's go ahead and get started on that. I like to use upside down half slabs for the house. The only thing, later Milbs, the only thing that I use the full thingy for is the corners where it's being supported. So, let's go ahead and break these because this is going to have to be broken eventually. Right here. Anders keeps leaving, joining. I think he's definitely having some connection issues. Damn internets. Alright, so the corner... Oh man, that is annoying. So let's say that... Yeah, these go here. Oh, no. Don't toss those. Like this, and then the next one goes here. Oh, not there. Let's break it with our shovel. Goes right there. So the house is going to start here. So this is one corner of the house, and let's make the other corner. Use some dirt here. Oh, that noise. Is this driving you guys nuts? Because it's driving me nuts. Yeah, let's make this one way out here so that I have a nice long fence post leading down. But we're going to have to do this. Is it? It's night now, right? Yeah, okay. So come morning, we'll let those guys out. Whoa! Was not expecting that. Alright, let's, can we reach from here? Yeah, we sure can. Dang it! That was gonna happen. And, of course, I only got one back. The one's up here. Let's go ahead and grab that. Okay. I wish there was an easier way to place upside-down half slabs. But there isn't. Okay. Man, this thing's a machine. Okay, so that's going to be the house. So we'll have our fence posts coming in like this. Oh, no, that's too high. That's too high. This is what we want down. Oh, my God. Jesus, I gotta stop using this shovel. This is a mass murder shovel, not a precision tool. Don't need our axe anymore, do we? We have our shovel. Okay, like this, and then this goes like this. Beautiful. We'll have our dark wood logs over here, like that. Okay. Okay, that'll work out nicely. On this side, don't really want to destroy this part here, but they can jump up. So maybe we'll just, well, Nah, I think we have to destroy the leaves. It would look weird if the fence post was on top of the leaves. So, oh my God! I swear I'm just hitting it once. Like tapping it, lightly tapping it. I better just use my hands. So we'll do this. Beautiful. Oh, this is nice. Might as well take this down here so we see the full effect. Zombie? Oh yeah, zombie. You're getting your butt kicked. Oh, but now you're on top of the roof. Man, he hit you so hard, he sent you flying. Yeah, you're gonna get beating. Go kill him. Go kill him, buddy. Why aren't you killing him? You're just watching him. Oh, he's taunting him. That's what he's doing.
Hey, zombie. You're stupid. You stupid zombie.
I'm starving here. Oh, and I got another great suggestion that I'm definitely gonna implement is because these are all three high, the houses. I'm going to build the snow golems inside the house. I think this is big, tall enough, isn't it? Two, three, yeah. So I'm going to build a snow golem inside each and every one of these houses, or at least the ones that they fit in, so that if zombies do manage to break down the door and go after the testificate, the snow... Did I say snow golems? Sorry, iron golems could go ahead and destroy their faces. Yeah. Okay, so we got this going here. Got a nice little walkway up. Might as well... this works out nicely. I don't have to kill these leaves at all. I'm going to leave this part open. Because... Can we put... No, we can't. Because we gotta do that. Yeah, there we go. Because, yeah, this walkway is going to lead somewhere else. Maybe we'll have one of those little sky bridges here and have a house there. Although those trees don't look high enough to really have houses. Let's close it off for now. Like I said, I'm going to let the other dudes loose. Maybe. Maybe I shouldn't. If I lose one, I will be very upset. It doesn't look like they can... escape from anywhere, but who knows? This is a nice place. I like this place. Got a nice view. High on the hill. Let's go check on them, actually. Maybe they've produced a baby. Please produce a baby. Let's go and have a closer look. I'll show you guys exactly what it looks like in there. Oh, that zombie's getting pwned. Mm-hmm. That's right, I said pwned. Pause. Nope. Nope. So, what's going on in here? See, two of you. The same two. Yeah, these guys aren't gonna breed in here, are they? I put these doors in here too, just trying to make makeshift houses, but that doesn't seem to be working. Nothing seems to be working. These two just don't love each other. Huh, dude? You gonna... See, this thing here is supposed to be enclosed. There's supposed to be a guy in here. Alright, like this guy. And then I was gonna close it all up. Dan, you played DayZ 2. Haven't saw you upload a video of it, but haven't had time to watch it. Haven't? Yesterday. What do you think? It's fun. It's fun. About the game, of course. Not sure if it is going to be a regular thing I do, but it is a good game. So yeah, DayZ. If you guys haven't seen that, you should check it out. It was fun to record with Badge and Paws. They obviously hate each other. It's super obvious that they hate each other. They're always yelling at each other. Oh look, another Iron Golem decided to join our little fun here. And these guys are just patrolling. Alright, so let's continue. Well, I guess we could put the half slabs. I only have three left, really? Well, that was fun. So yet either of it regularly, but I sure will play in my free time. Yeah. It gets intense sometimes. Oh, okay. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and make, I don't want this video to be too long. I don't have too much time to upload today, so I'm going to go ahead and make half slabs and gather all the wood I need, and then we're going to finish this thing off. Ouch! Okay, floor complete. Let us tear away this dirt, huh? Like a boss. Beautiful. Oh yeah, look at this beautiful floor. Mm-hmm. Get this out of here. Okay, next, we gotta use our dark wood. And I know dark wood probably isn't the best wood to use for this because this is a jungle and the dark wood is like from snow biomes. but I like the look of the dark wood. So there, eat it. We're gonna make this one. You know what? This one should be like a panoramic view here. I don't even know if I'll have enough. I don't know if I'll have enough glass for it, but this is gonna be a nice one. Basically, there's like high-end houses in the jungle. As high-end as you can be with wood and glass. That's all it really is. Just wood and glass. Oh, that's a nice view here, though. It's going to have a nice view of the ship port or the fishing dock or something. Whatever's going to be down there. All right, and let's continue this going here like that. Perfect. We'll have double doors again. I like double doors. Single doors just looks really claustrophobic to me. Could it be that the... Oh, I can't place... Oh, I forgot. I gotta do that. I gotta put full blocks there because you can't place doors on upside down half slabs. That's cool. There we go. Alright. Man, those doors downstairs are super annoying. I know. I'm sorry. I'll get rid of them soon. I might as well get rid of all these wood blocks because, yeah, we're going to have to go chop down. I'm going to chop down a bunch more. Well, I don't have to actually chop down. I just got to go visit the castle and pick up a bunch of the wood that's already chopped. Let's do this. Okay, now, let's half slab the outside. The bottom half of these blocks here. Okay. I'm really having fun doing this project, guys, too. I mean, I know that some of you want to work on a castle. And I definitely want to finish the castle, but for now, this is a nice break. It's weird, because sometimes I want to play Minecraft, and I feel like building, and this was before I started this project, I feel like just building something small or whatever, and I really didn't have an outlet to do that because of, because the castle is just a huge project, so every time I felt like building, it was like, oh man, but if I want to build, I gotta go ahead and work on this enormous part of this castle, which is gonna take forever, and it's gonna be super boring because it's just a straight wall, mostly straight walls. So yeah, this is a nice change to have. I can come over here, build a quick little house, break wood with my shovel. So I'm really enjoying this project, and I know a lot of you are as well, and I'm glad to hear it. Go ahead and put torches in the corner. What's the block light out over here? 10. So we're good. Nothing will spawn in here. Let's go take a look at it from... How are we going to get out of here? Oh, no, we don't have a way out here, do we? Yeah, we do. We sure do. That means these guys can get out as well. Let's go ahead and put torches. Put one there. And one here. Now, let's go and take a look. Ouch. What that looks like from over this side of the place. Yeah, I like that. That's definitely the look I want. And you know, I might just build a couple more houses directly below it and have this be like a huge sort of complex here. Maybe even ladders between them, or stairways between them. Huh. I like that. That's might work out well, actually. But yeah, I'm gonna leave it at this for this episode. I know it wasn't an hour long, because I can't make them all an hour long, guys. I really can't. I know you guys enjoyed that hour long episode, though. That was fun. That was a really good video. Look, these guys are in the water again. Look at how many are out here. This is how I got him out last time. By the way, before they were down here, I just hit him a couple times. There you go. You're back on land now. So are you. Back on land. And you? back on land. Come on, keep going, keep going. You dummy. How about you? Is there anybody else really far down? You get up there. This guy just does not want to go. Oh, because it's too high, I think. No, it's only one high. Why won't you get up there? There you go. This guy's patrolling the shores. I wish they didn't walk into the water. It'd be cool if they just patrolled the whole edge of the island. By the way, this is an island. In case you didn't know, this is a tiny little island. It's half jungle and half, I don't know what those, forest? Is it forest? Let's go take a quick look. Half jungle and half, and I started replacing this to make it look more natural. So far, so good. Not done yet, though, but, alright, what are we at over here? This is beach. No, this is not where we want to be. What is this? Forest, yeah. Half jungle, half forest. There's some cows here. Oh, they're going to have farms too in here. Livestock pens and stuff. It's going to be like a regular little village. I might even make a little hospital. Have a Red Cross on there somewhere. But it's looking pretty cool. Now, imagine this little section, but spread out along most of the island. I think it'll look amazing. And it's going to be wonderful. And as soon as these villagers start breeding, then I can let them out. And even if a couple of them do get killed, if I have enough of them, then it won't matter, will it? No, it won't. I answered my own question. That is lame. Before we go, let's take one last look. See if these guys made babies. I'm not going to let them out today. I'm still very afraid that they'll disappear on me. And I'll never see them again. Ah, there's still nothing. Man. They have a ton of doors. They have a ton of houses out here. There's only two of them. Why don't you breed, damn it? I gotta get Doc on this. Gotta get Doc, the expert. The villager breeding expert in on this. What's back here? That looks wrong. Let's just cover that up. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you have any ideas for the village, I'd love... Whoa, no. What am I doing? I almost made a huge mistake. If you have any ideas for the village, then let me hear them. Like I said, I'm going to make livestock pens, and there's going to be hospitals, a fishing dock, or a yard, fishing yard, a port maybe, for people to come in on the boats. There's going to be houses up in the tall jungle trees with walkways in between them. But other than that, if you have any other ideas, I would welcome them. I would definitely listen and probably implement some of them. And if you have any ideas on how to make these guys breed, you can let me know that as well, because I'm fresh out. I mean, I'm building houses like a maniac. There's only two of these guys, so I believe the percentage is villagers will populate 38% of the amount of houses you have. So, with that in mind, there's only two of them, so there should be at least a couple more villagers already. I'm not sure what else to do. I'm so sad. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the episode. Hope you enjoyed the episode, and I will see you guys next time.